Bien, lección 5. Vamos a comenzar. Hoy vamos a repasar la ropa y los verbos regulares. Y hoy vamos a empezar a comparar directamente el verbo ser y estar juntos. Y vamos a aprender el verbo irregular tener también. Okay. Did you do your homework for lesson 4?
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember.
I finished it on Friday night, Saturday morning, something like that.
Okay.
I think I finished it Friday night.
Okay, cool. I'm not sure if I've seen it yet.
Okay.
But hopefully today I'll
get there was it. One, though, I did mark in there. All it said was description, and I was like, so I typed in there, all this says is description, so I'm not sure what the question is. So you'll see that when you look on there.
Yeah, the application is a work in progress, so.
That's fine.
There is, yeah.
Yeah, it's all good.
All right. Okay, so, ser o estar. Which verb do we use with our temporary states of being that can be defined by this position, location, action, condition, emotion, or in other words, place acronym?
Estar.
This is estar. Muy bien. So this is kind of the first step, right? Is being able to kind of recognize which you use. What about for the more permanent states of beings?
Ser.
Ser. Exactly. Muy bien. Okay, vamos a practicar. ¿Dónde está Argentina?
So I'm trying to think what I would say. Like, so would I say like está in Sudamérica? South America?
Está en Sudamérica. Okay. ¿Cómo es Dwayne Johnson?
Dwayne Johnson es what is that word? I was trying to say strong and I can't remember what it is. ¿Cómo se dice strong?
Es fuerte.
Fuerte.
Muy bien. ¿Cómo es el niño?
El niño es... I'm not getting that all of a sudden. I'm trying to remember. El niño es... Ah, I can't believe I forgot it. Débil.
Débil. Mm-hmm. El niño es débil. ¿Cómo están ellos?
Están contenta, contento. No, it's plural. Están contentos.
Muy bien. And here we have están emocionados por la ciudadanía estadounidense.
Okay.
But what you said, están contentos, is 100% acceptable.
Okay.
¿De qué es el puente?
¿De qué es el puente? No entiendo.
What is the bridge made of?
Oh, what is the bridge made of? El puente es concreto?
Concreto? So typically bridges are made out of steel.
Are they? Okay.
Acero.
Okay, acero. I was thinking it was either steel or concrete, but I couldn't tell.
That's okay.
Exactly.
No.
Okay. Es de acero.
¿Cómo estás?
Estoy. Yeah. Estoy contenta.
Bien. ¿Cuál es su profesión?
Soy asistente.
Not your profession, her profession.
Oh, her profession. Okay. I'm trying to remember what the word is. ¿Cómo se dice administrator?
So we're looking for secretary.
Secretary. Okay.
Secretaria.
Okay, secretaria. Okay.
¿Cómo está la copa?
La copa está vacío.
Vacía.
Vacía.
¿Cómo es ella?
ella es muy alta.
¿Cómo es él?
Él es bajo.
¿Y cómo están ellos?
Están what is the word? Enamorado?
There you go. Están enamorados. Make it plural.
Enamorados. Okay.
Muy bien. Muy bien. You're doing great, Angela. ¿De qué es la copa?
La copa es llena.
All right. So, ¿de qué es la copa?
¿De qué es? Oh.
What is it made of?
Oh, what is it made of? Right. I keep forgetting de qué means. All right. So la copa es vidria.
Es de vidrio.
Es de vidria. Vidrio.
¿Cómo está ella?
Ella está. Oh, which one is it? Casada.
Cansada.
Cansada.
¿Cómo es el niño?
el niño es emocionado.
So careful. That would be if it were como está.
Oh, right. So it's soy emocionada. Emocionado.
That's what I'm trying
to say. Is that what we're looking for?
Emocionado is going to go with the verb estar.
Oh, yeah.
Here we're looking for a physical description, right? So, él es joven.
Oh, okay. So, you're looking, okay. Yeah.
Because
way off. Okay. So,
you were trying to tie it with an emotion.
Right.
So, that's where the, you know, knowing the difference between ser and estar come in.
Right. Okay. So they were looking for her.
Because you're right. Él está emocionado or él mm-hmm. está contento, pero él es joven.
Okay.
And that directly.
So he's young, right. Es joven. Okay.
¿Cómo es el abuelo?
El abuelo es viejo.
¿Dónde está Evo Morales?
Evo Morales está en Bolivia.
¿Cómo es el vagabundo?
El vagabundo es. Okay, so it's ser. So we're looking for permanent term. No lo sé. I'm not sure. What are we?
We're looking for he is poor.
Oh, poor. Okay.
Es pobre.
Okay. I was like, I'm not really sure okay. So, el vagabundo es pobre.
Yeah. I mean, there's a million things that you could say.
Right.
¿De qué es el sacapuntas?
El sacapuntas es plástico.
Es de plástico.
Keep forgetting the day.
¿Cómo está la maestra?
Emocionada.
Emocionada is more of a good thing, you know?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out.
Frustrada.
Oh, okay. I was like, I don't know how to say upset. So, okay. Let me write that down. Frustrada. Is that how you say it?
Mm-hmm.
Frustrada. Okay. There we go.
¿De qué es el caballo?
El caballo es... What's the word I'm looking for? El caballo es madre... What I say? Madero?
Es de madera.
Es de madero. Madera. Okay. So do I put an O on there or no?
I'm sorry?
Do I make it masculine or does it stay just the same?
No, that's what I was just about to explain to you. Oh. So wood is a noun, which
means
it's always going to be madera.
Okay. So es de madera.
¿Cuál es su profesión?
Es policía.
Muy bien. ¿De qué es el edificio?
El edificio es acero.
So this one is de concreto.
Oh, okay. It looked like steel. I was like, okay.
¿Cómo está el perro?
Está incómodo.
Muy bien. El pobrecito. ¿De qué es la casa?
La casa es concreta.
Es de...
es de...
Careful, this is brick, not concrete.
Oh, yeah, that's... Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why I said that. Es de ladrillo.
Muy bien.
Oh my goodness.
¿Cómo está la gatita?
Oh my gosh. Está está morado.
Mojado. Mojado. Morado means purple.
Yeah, I was like, I knew it starts with the M. Okay. Mojada.
Yeah, and here we have está mojada porque es la gatita.
Yeah, what is gatita? Is that like little cat?
Yep.
Oh, cool.
¿De qué es la camiseta?
Which one is it? Es de algodón.
Muy bien. ¿Cómo es Bill Gates?
He's not old. Es viejo? Would you use that?
You could. So people normally know.
Oh, okay. Rich. Okay. I don't know why I was. Rich,
right?
Yeah. Okay. I wasn't even thinking about that.
We didn't have any money in the background.
Yeah.
¿De qué es la chaqueta?
La chaqueta es ¿cómo se dice? Leather? Is that what we're looking for?
Mm-hmm. Es de cuero.
Cuero. Leather. Okay.
Uf, ¿cómo está el doctor?
Oh my gosh. Okay. Is it deprimido?
Or... Está deprimido.
Yeah. Good lord. es estudiante.
Muy bien. ¿Cuál es su profesión?
Es maestro.
¿Cómo está la recepcionista?
Está aburrido. ¿Aburrida?
Aburrida.
Mm-hmm. Aburrida.
¿Cuál es su profesión?
¿Cómo se dice firefighter?
Ajá, él es bombero.
Bombero, okay. Bombero. Firefighter. Okay.
Sí. Yeah. ¿Cómo es Shaq?
Shaq es alto.
¿Cómo es su mujer?
Es baja.
¿Cómo está mi amiga por la mañana?
Está emocionada.
Mm-hmm. I'll accept that. Here we have
Estar yeah.
despierta, but I'll
keep forgetting awake. Despierta.
¿Cuál es su profesión?
ella es. Oh shoot! I forgot what nurse was. ¿Cómo se dice nurse?
Enfermera.
Enfermera. That's what it is. Enfermera.
Muy bien. Tener is an irregular verb, Angela. Oh. You've already seen, you know, it's been mildly introduced to us, but mm-hmm. the full conjugation looks like this. Yo tengo.
Yo tengo.
Yo tengo.
Yo tengo.
Tú tienes.
Tú tienes.
Él tiene.
Él tiene.
Ella tiene.
Ella tiene.
Usted tiene.
Usted tiene.
Nosotros tenemos.
Nosotros tenemos.
Ellos tienen.
Ellos tienen.
Ellas tienen.
Ellas tienen.
Ustedes tienen.
Ustedes tienen.
Muy bien. Complete the blanks here.
Okay. Yo tengo una televisión grande. Mis vecinos tenemos gabinetes.
Mis vecinos would not be the same as nosotros.
Oh no, because that's not saying we. You're saying they. Mis vecinos tienen gabinetes lindos.
Muy bien.
Tú tienes tres perros.
Muy bien.
Nosotros tenemos una cocina con acabados nuevos. Él tiene un baño pequeño. Yo no tengo una chimenea. Ella tiene toallas sucias. Ella tiene una mesa de madera. Nosotros tenemos un comedor. Tú tienes un dormitorio bueno.
¿Tienes una televisión grande, Ángela?
Sí, tengo una televisión grande.
¿Tus vecinos tienen el césped más verde que el tuyo?
¿Qué significa césped?
Grass.
So, green grass.
Is your neighbor's grass greener than yours?
Oh, greener than yours. sí. Mis vecinos tienen. Yeah, sí.
¿tienes mascotas?
Sí, tengo uno perro.
Tengo un perro.
Un perro.
¿Nosotros tenemos muchos alumnos en la clase hoy?
No, nosotros no tenemos muchos alumnos. I think I said that right.
Mm-hmm. ¿Tu mejor amigo o tu mejor amiga tiene un apartamento?
No, mi mejor amigo no tiene un apartamento, pero una casa. Yeah.
Chimenea?
Sí. Tengo dos chimeneas.
Muy bien. ¿Tu mamá tiene toallas grandes?
¿Qué significa toallas? I forgot what that word was.
Towels.
Towels. Sí, mi mamá tiene toallas grandes.
Toallas.
Toallas. Okay. Toallas.
¿Tu esposo tiene buen gusto?
Do you have a good... Sí. Tengo... Esposo tiene buen gusto.
You might not
think that's... No, hang on. I'm trying to figure out how to answer that.
So the question is not about you. It's about your husband. Does your husband have nice taste?
Oh, nice taste. Okay. Yeah, I was thinking that was... Okay, never mind. I was thinking that was something completely different. Sí, mi esposo tiene buen gusto.
Okay. Muy bien. ¿Y tu mamá... ¿Nosotros tenemos una mesa de plástico?
I'll just say, sí, nosotros tenemos una mesa de plástico.
¿Tú tienes un dormitorio bueno?
Do you have a good room? Is that what that's asking?
Yeah, good bedroom.
Okay. Sí, tengo un dormitorio bueno.
Muy bien. All right. So, making it relevant, okay? We can use this verb tener to talk about the type of house that you live in. And overall, mm-hmm. just more vocab related to where you live. So, mm-hmm. We've got words like un edificio de apartamentos, una casa bifamiliar, una casa en hileras, un condominio, una casa móvil. ¿En cuál tipo de residencia vives, Ángela?
So it's asking what type. ¿Qué significa? I'm not sure what the question's asking.
Yeah, what type of residence do you live in?
Okay. What type of residence do you live in? Vivo en una casa.
Bien. ¿En cuál tipo de comunidad vives? ¿Vives en una granja, un rancho, una ciudad, en los suburbios, en el campo, un pueblo?
Vivo en los suburbios. That's hard to say. Suburbio. I can't say it. Say it again.
Suburbios.
Suburbios. Suburbios. That's a mouthful.
All right. We're going to talk about tu habitat, your habitat. Okay. I need to know words like también or tampoco.
Oh, that's what tampoco means. Okay. I've seen that word a whole bunch of times, but I never knew what it meant. Okay.
Yep. El dormitorio, el patio, el baño, la sala, la cocina, o el comedor. Mi casa es chica. Está ubicada en Montbello, en la calle Deep Haven. Es amarilla. No es nueva, pero tampoco es vieja. Es del año 83. Tiene 3 dormitorios y 2 baños. Todos los cuartos son pequeños. Me gusta la sala. Me gustaría una cocina más grande. Hay un árbol en el patio de enfrente y otro detrás de la casa. Tengo mucho trabajo que hacer afuera. Okay. So, I want you to describe your house. Describe tu casa con tener, estar, y ser, okay?
Oh, boy.
So you could do this as just a little writing activity, okay?
Okay. This is going to be hard. Mm. Wrong one.
Still working?
Well, I'm stuck on something and I'm trying to figure out how I want to say it. I'm trying to say my living room is a little big. I know that kind of is like oxymoron, but I want to say like it's big, but I don't want to be like I have a very big living room. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I don't know how I would actually describe that. If I should just say it's big or.
Yeah. So, you could say me la sala, like how I have it here.
Mm-hmm.
Where I say mi casa no es nueva, pero tampoco es vieja. Mm-hmm. So, you could say something like that. La sala no es grande, pero tampoco es chica.
Okay.
Es mediana. Oh, it's normal, right?
Okay.
It's not big, it's not small. It's medium-sized.
Okay.
Normal, it's a normal
size. So, all right, let me write that down. So you said, mi sala es tampoco? Is that what you said?
Mi sala no es grande.
No es grande.
Pero tampoco es pequeña.
No es grande. So, mi sala no es grande. And then, sorry, what'd you say?
Pero tampoco. No es pequeña.
No es pequeña. Is normal. Okay. I think I'm good.
Okay.
Okay.
What you got?
So, vivo en una casa en Belleville, Illinois. Mi casa es grande. Tengo tres dormitorios y dos baños. Y grande patio.
Real quick here, yes. To go back to where you said tengo tres dormitorios.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to. I mean, that's perfectly acceptable to say it that way. But just to give you the practice with the word I, this mm-hmm. would be a good place for you to say I tres dormitorios. There are three bedrooms.
Oh, okay.
Instead of saying like I have three bedrooms, because that just...
Okay. So Tango, I would be there are.
Why does she need so many bedrooms? The house has three bedrooms.
Right. No. So I tres instead of Tango tres.
Yeah. H-A-Y. Okay. There is or there are.
Okay. I keep forgetting about that word. Okay. So I tres. So hay tres dormitorios.
That's why I wanted you to use it, because I know it's a word that people tend to forget.
Yeah.
And like, so this is like a perfect opportunity for you to use it.
Okay. So hay tres dormitorios y dos baños y grande patio. No me gusta mi cocina porque es muy pequeño.
Pequeña.
No tengo comedor, pero mi sala no es grande, pero tampoco no es pequeña. Mm-hmm. Es normal. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Sí.
Okay. That's what I got.
Okay. Nice job on her, though. I like that. Good description. All right. So to continue, the Spanish tip, relevance. You know, this is so important to make Spanish relevant. So, Angela, mm-hmm. why are you learning Spanish, right? So you might be learning it for work, for your community, for travel, mm-hmm. for dating, for family, etc. These are just mm-hmm. some common reasons I get. Why are you learning Spanish? Now, you take it to the next level and think of five activities that you would be doing in that situation. So, for example, if you're learning Spanish for work, what are five activities that you would do at work?
That regard me learning Spanish? Is that what you're saying?
So why are you learning Spanish? What situation in your life would you have a practice for learning Spanish?
Porque hablo con mi amiga.
Okay, so for like community or for friendship or for family, mm-hmm. right? So think of five activities that you would do with your friend. And ask me how to say those activities. I'm just trying to personalize it for you.
Right.
To give you some specific words that you could talk about with your friend.
Right.
Common situation. Is that your friend that lives here? No.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. ¿Cómo se dice traveling?
Viajar.
So
there's one activity. Viajar, right?
Mm-hmm.
Muy bien. What's another activity?
Write that down so I don't forget it. Trying to think how I want to say it. Hablar por teléfono, to talk on the phone. You know, talk back and forth.
Yeah.
So would that be hablar?
Para hablar por teléfono, muy bien.
Okay, so para hablar por teléfono. Let's see. Travel, talk on the phone. I guess we could listen to music together.
Okay, para escuchar música.
Para escuchar música.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's see. Uno, dos, tres. Maybe to watch a Spanish movie together. I don't know. Watch a movie together.
Para ver películas.
Para. What'd you say?
Para ver películas.
The ER, ver.
Mm-hmm.
ver películas. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Gosh, I don't know. So the first one was to travel, but like to travel to see each other. But like if I wanted to say to vacation together, how would I say that?
Para ir de vacaciones.
What was it?
Para ir de vacaciones.
De la vacaciones?
No. Para ir, I-R, mm-hmm. ir right. de vacaciones.
Oh, okay. I don't know why I thought you put a la in there. How do you spell it again? I'm having a brain fart.
It's like literally the same. Vacaciones, okay. Vacation. The only difference is
yes.
Where there's a T, you replace the T with a C.
Okay. That's what I was. I don't know why I was thinking it was somewhere else. Okay. Vacaciones. Okay. Cool.
Muy bien.
Nice.
So, like, you can see how you can use these words next time you practice with her, right?
Yeah. I know sometimes, like, when she talks to me, I'll do, like, the little translate thing that I got in there, and I try to, like, text her in Spanish, even though I don't know, like, all the words, and I have to, like, look it up. But that way there, when I'm looking at it, I can kind of, like, practice when I'm looking at old text or something. But, yeah.
Muy bien. Okay, vamos a escuchar una canción en español, una canción muy famosa.
Happy
Canción Colombia. La camisa negra. So the black shirt.
Yep. All right. And now I'm going to share the lyrics with you. Super duper famous song in Spanish that we're going to listen to. Okay.
Cool.
All ready? Así como lo oí, hija.
camisa negra. Ya tu amor no me interesa. Lo que ayer me supo a gloria, hoy me sabe a pura. Miércoles por la tarde y tú que no llegas, ni siquiera muestras señas. Y yo con la camisa negra y tus maletas en la puerta. Mal parece que solo me quedé y fue pura todita tu mentira. Qué maldita mala suerte la mía, que aquel día te encontré por beber del veneno malevo. Negra, porque negra tengo el alma. Yo por ti perdí la calma y casi pierdo hasta mi cama. Cama, 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 baby, te digo con disimulo que tengo la camisa negra y debajo tengo el difunto. Tengo la camisa negra, porque negra tengo el alma. Yo por ti perdí la calma y casi pierdo hasta mi cama. Cama, cama, cama.
Okay.
Interesting song.
How'd you do with that song?
Not well.
No?
I mean, like, some of them I know the words, but others I'm like, yeah, I don't know. I was going to try writing them down, and I was like, I'll be writing down half the lyrics.
Yeah, there's probably a lot of new vocab in this, but anything in particular you want to ask me about?
So, like, it says, I have a black shirt today, my love, or now? I always forget what oy is. Is it oy?
Today.
Today, my love.
So write that word down.
What?
Oy. So if that's a word that you always forget, then write
it. I always get it mixed up with now.
Yeah.
And now is which one?
Ahora.
Ahora. Okay.
Yeah. So anytime you have words like that that challenge you,
ahora,
write them down and keep going back to them.
Okay. So no. That means today. And that means now. Yeah, I always get those two mixed up.
Yeah.
So today, my love, ¿qué significa luto?
Está de luto means is mourning. My love is mourning. Why do people wear black clothes? To go to funerals.
Oh, like, right? And, you know, God.
This song has kind of a double meaning to it, right? He's talking about, right. He's wearing his black shirt like as if he were going to a funeral for his own love, his heart. His heart has been broken.
Okay.
His heart has been broken. His ability to love has been killed. He's in mourning.
Es por culpa de tu embrujo. ¿Qué significa?
Yeah, because of your witchcraft, essentially.
Oh, okay. Very depressing song.
Yeah, it's funny because it sounds happy and upbeat.
Yeah.
But then when you start actually listening to the lyrics, it gets really... really depressing. I had a student once that, because this is a really popular song, like if you've ever been to a Spanish nightclub or to something like that, more than likely this song will come on.
Oh, that's funny.
And so this one of my students was saying how often he's heard it, and you know, he gets all happy and kind of upbeat and starts kind of dancing around. And then we started translating the lyrics, and he's like, oh man, what a bummer.
Very goth song.
Yeah. So this is an artist named Juanes. He's from Colombia.
Cool.
And he's a really popular artist in Latin America. So if you like this style of music, check out Juanes. You know, you could add some of his songs to the listening activities. And this is going to be more on kind of the Spanish rock side of things.
Oh, cool. That's neat.
To give you a little exposure to
Did
that.
Did I ever tell you about the guy that I used to listen to when I was first learning Spanish? Alejandro Sanchez or something?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I saw something on Twitter or whatever. He had posted something after, like, forever. And I was like, oh, this is weird. I haven't seen that name in a long time.
Really? Yeah. 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 I think he's from Colombia too, maybe.
Oh, really?
I can't remember. So yeah, we're listening to this song, La Camisa Negra, porque hoy vamos a hablar de la ropa. Today we're going to talk about clothing. Okay.
Okay.
Ángela, ¿cómo es el sombrero?
¿Cómo es? How is the sombrero?
What's the sombrero like?
Oh, what is it? Okay. Es... Would I say... What's the word I'm looking for? Would I say, like, what's it made out of?
Just describe it, you know.
Okay. Es azul y rojo y blanco y negro. Es grande.
Bien. ¿Cómo es la blusa?
La blusa es algodón.
Es de algodón. Es de
algodón. Es de algodón. Y I'm trying to tell if that's like pink or red. roja. Yeah. I can't tell if it's red or whatever.
That's fine. ¿Cómo es la camisa?
La camisa es azul.
¿Y cómo es la camiseta?
La camiseta es azul y amarilla. No.
Muy bien. Ajá, yeah. Sí. ¿Cómo es el polo?
El polo es blanco.
Muy bien. ¿Cómo es la corbata?
La corbata es mojado.
That would be wet.
I don't know why I keep wanting to mix purple and wet together. I don't know why.
Because they're very similar. They're only off by one level. By only one letter.
Okay.
Morada.
Morada.
Es morada. ¿Cómo es la chaqueta?
La chaqueta es azul y gris.
¿Cómo es el cinturón?
El cinturón es marrón. Brown.
¿Cómo es la ropa interior?
Es blanco, es rojo, es negro.
¿Cómo es el vestido?
El vestido es... amarillo, sí, amarillo.
¿Cómo es la falda?
La falda es is it marrón claro? I'm trying to say light brown.
It's more of a green kind of color.
Oh, okay.
That's fine. If you want to say marrón claro, I'll accept it. That's fine.
Okay. Look brown for some reason.
¿Cómo son los pantalones?
Los pantalones son azul.
Yeah, and here you'd make that plural. Azules.
Oh, yeah. I keep forgetting that. Azules.
¿Cómo son las zapatillas?
Las zapatillas son marrones.
Marrones, muy bien.
Marrones.
¿Y cómo son los calcetines?
Los calcetines son rojo y verde y amarillo. Yeah.
All right. Quick little review of the simple present tense in Spanish. So you've learned, you know, we've got our regular AR verbs, right? Mm-hmm. And kind of the most important thing is to be able to ask questions and answer them, right? ¿Tú llevas una blusa? Sí, yo llevo una blusa. Ángela, ¿tú llevas un sombrero con frecuencia?
¿Qué significa llevas? I forgot that word.
Do you wear? In this situation,
oh, do you wear?
Llevar is to wear or to take or to carry.
Okay. No llevo un sombrero.
Muy bien. ¿Llevas una blusa o una camisa a tu trabajo?
¿Cómo se dice? I wear both.
Llevo las... llevo las dos.
Llevo las dos.
Llevo...
Oh, llevo las dos.
Las dos. ¿Con qué frecuencia llevas un polo?
And that's saying how frequently do I wear a polo?
Yep.
Okay. ¿Cómo se dice? I want to say very rarely.
Sí, llevo un polo o no llevo un polo mucho o llevo un polo poco. Llevo un polo poco.
Okay, llevo un polo poco.
¿Llevas calcetines con sandalias?
So is that saying, do I wear socks with sandals?
Yes.
Okay. No llevo calcetines con sandales.
So we're gonna we're going back to review the simple present tense, mm-hmm. right? We've got three regular verb types. We've got our AR, our ER, and our IR verbs. Okay. Yep.
Finished AR. I remember that.
Yep. I want to go back since it's kind of odd starting
with
AR, but so let's just go back and review these AR real quick. So all these are the endings. So remember, you take a regular verb that ends with AR, you take away those two letters, the AR letters, and then you add back these endings. Yo o, tú has, él ha, ella ha, usted ha. Nosotros amos, ellos han, ellas han, ustedes han.
Mm-hmm.
And so then just run through the cycle here with hablar for me.
Okay, so yo hablo, tú hablas, él habla, ella habla, usted habla, nosotros hablamos, ellos hablan, ellas hablan, ustedes hablan.
Muy bien, Angela. Okay. Take three of these verbs and conjugate them for me.
Okay, so yo escucho, tú escuchas, él escucha, ella escucha, usted escucha, nosotros escuchamos, ellos escuchan, ellas escuchan, ustedes escuchan.
Muy bien.
Trabajo, trabajas, nosotros trabajamos, and trabajan.
Good.
Let's do charlo, charlas. Charla, charlamos, and charlan.
Muy bien. All right. Fill in the blanks.
Okay. Yo charlo. Tú.
Read the full sentence, though.
Oh, sorry. Yo charlo con mis colegas en español. Tú revisas el correo electrónico.
Correo.
Correo. Yeah. El asistente apunta los asuntos importantes en la reunión. Reunión. Los empleados escuchan al director ejecutivo. Alberto gana un buen salario. Mariela y Julieta regresan a sus cubículos. Yo compro los materiales de oficina. Mis compañeros de trabajo llevan trajes elegantes.
Muy bien.
Verónica trabaja 11 horas de al día.
And this one is 12.
Tú preparas el reporte para el jefe. Los vendedores visitan a los clientes.
Bien.
Yo estoy en la oficina.
Muy bien. Ángela, ¿bailas con frecuencia?
No bailo.
¿Hablas con tu familia frecuentemente?
Sí, hablo con mi familia cada día.
¿Dónde compras los víveres?
Compro los víveres en un supermercado.
¿Y la ropa? ¿Dónde compras la ropa?
¿Cómo se dice? ¿Like a mall?
Ajá, un centro comercial.
Un centro comercial.
Muy bien. Ángela, okay. ¿Bailas la salsa?
No bailo.
¿Cantas en la ducha?
¿Cómo se dice cantas?
Do you sing in the shower?
sí, a veces.
¿Escuchas a Ricky Martin?
Escucho a Ricky Martin a veces.
¿Ganas la lotería?
No gano.
¿Tocas algún instrumento?
Toco un poco. I play a little.
Uh-huh.
El piano.
Toco el piano un poco.
Toco el piano un poco.
Muy bien. ¿Regresas a casa después de clase?
Just a second. Toco el piano. I keep wanting to put un poco before that. Piano un poco. Okay, sorry. We're on 9.
¿Regresas a casa después de clase?
¿Cómo se dice? ¿Qué significa regresas?
So regresar is the verb to return or to go back. So regresas a casa. Do you go back home after class?
sí, regresó a casa después de clase.
Okay. ¿Trabajas por la noche?
No trabajo por la noche, pero trabajo en la mañana.
Muy bien. ¿Esquías en Bale?
No esquío.
¿Visitas a tu familia por las fiestas de Navidad?
Sí, visito mi familia a veces. Bien. I visit them sometimes.
Bien. All right. So same thing with the ER verbs, right? You're going to take away that ER ending, and then you add back these endings. Yo, o. Repeat after me. Yo, o.
Yo, o.
Tú, es.
Tú, es.
Él, es.
Él, es.
Ella, es.
Ella, es.
Usted, es.
Usted, es.
Nosotros, hemos.
Nosotros, hemos.
Ellos, en.
Ellos, en.
Ellas, en.
Ellas, en.
Ustedes, en.
Ustedes, en.
Yo, como.
Yo, como.
Tú, comes.
Tú, comes.
Él, come.
Él, come.
Ella, come.
Ella, come.
Usted come.
Usted come.
Nosotros comemos.
Nosotros comemos.
Ellos comen.
Ellos comen.
Ellas comen.
Ellas comen.
Ustedes comen.
Ustedes comen.
Okay. So, do you know what all these verbs here mean? Beber.
Beber is to drink.
Comer.
Is to eat.
Leer.
Leer is to read.
Aprender.
Aprender is to understand, right?
To learn. No,
to learn, to learn. That's what it was.
Aprender, to learn. I don't know if you want to write that one down. Any of these that you don't have 100% solid, you should write them down so you can hit them again.
Aprender to learn. Okay. Okay.
Correr.
Correr is to run.
Vender.
Vender. To buy?
The opposite, to sell.
Oh, that's what it was. Okay. I was like, I can't remember that one. Okay. To sell. Okay.
Prometer?
I don't think I know that one.
To promise.
Oh, nice. So, prometer. To promise. Prender.
Prender. So prender, not aprender, just prender means to turn on.
Oh, okay.
Like to turn on the TV or to turn on the car.
Interesting. Prender.
To turn a machine on.
To turn on. Okay.
Romper?
No, I've seen that a bunch of times, but I can't remember what it actually means.
To break.
Okay. Romper. To break. Okay.
Responder.
So would that be to respond?
Yeah, to respond or to answer.
Okay. I'm going to write that down. Responder to respond or answer. Okay. Deber. I don't know if I know that one.
Deber means to owe.
Oh, okay. Cool. To owe.
Yeah, and then you can use it as an auxiliary verb, like the way we use the word should.
Okay, like you should do something?
Debes estudiar. You should study.
Ah, sí. Interesting. Okay.
Cometer?
I don't think I know that one.
To commit.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Also used commonly, like cometer un error, to make a mistake.
Okay, so would you say originally it was to what?
To commit.
Commit.
Commit a crime, make a mistake. All right, so I want you to take three of these and conjugate them in the full form. Why don't you do it on paper?
I did this over the weekend.
Oh, okay, good. Now I can't go get the water that I wanted to go get.
Go ahead.
All right, I'll be right back.
I can wait.
Okay, so let me hear your conjugations for three of these.
Okay. I have beber. So yo bebo, tu bebes, el bebe, ella bebe, usted bebe, nosotros bebemos, ellos beben, ellas beben, ustedes beben.
Muy bien.
And then I have aprender. So aprendo. Tú aprendes. Él aprende. Ella aprende. Usted aprende. Nosotros aprendemos. Ellos aprenden. Ellas aprenden. Ustedes aprenden.
Good.
And then I chose the cometer. And so yo cometo.
Cometo.
Cometo. Tú cometes. Él comete.
Bien.
Ella comete. Usted comete. Nosotros cometemos. Ellos cometen, ellas cometen, ustedes cometen.
Muy bien, Angela. Perfecto.
Now, I got a question, because a friend of mine, his wife, he always tells her comete, and that's what I was thinking this word came from, but I was like, okay, well, apparently this is different since you told me what it actually means. Or comete. What actually does that mean, to be quiet? Like, is that a version of saying be quiet or calm down?
Cállate.
What is it?
With a double L. Cállate.
Oh, it always sounded like he was saying cálmate. Okay.
Maybe he's saying cálmate, calm down, cálmate.
Maybe.
Calmar, okay. C-A-L-M, like calm.
Uh-huh.
Calmar, cálmate.
Oh, maybe that's what he's saying. Because I was always curious. I was like, oh, this looks like the same word. But I didn't realize he was saying calmate. Huh.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard without being in the moment. But I would imagine that's probably...
Probably. Because she speaks Spanish. And that's one of the few words that he knows in Spanish. And so I was like, oh, okay. I thought it meant like to be quiet or something, but that makes more sense.
Yeah, well, cállate, but that's with a double L. Cállate?
Yeah, no.
Calm down.
I don't think he was saying that.
Cállate would mean to calm down, or, you know.
Yeah.
Settle down, calm down, cállate.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what he was saying. But anyways, so. okay. So, nosotros bebemos café en la reunión.
Reunión, sí.
Okay, reunión. Ellos deben revisar los contratos. Los aprendices leen... las políticas de la empresa. Los pasantes aprenden mucho en el trabajo. Yo como el almuerzo con mi patrona. El proveedor. Wait, no, I think I mixed one.
Yeah,
yeah. Sorry, I missed one. Mi colega corre a la reunión porque está tarde.
Muy bien.
El proveedor vende muchos productos. Yo no prometo nada a mis jefes.
Muy bien.
Daniel prende la computadora. Los abogados.
Abogados.
Oh, okay. So you do pronounce the G. Los abogados rompen el contrato. Los agentes, or is that right? Agentes. Los agentes de servicio al cliente responden con mucha paciencia. Los oficinistas son puntuales.
Muy bien, Ángela. ¿Comes la comida mexicana?
Sí, como la comida mexicana.
¿Bebes mucha agua cada día?
Sí, bebo 32 agua cada día. 32
onzas de agua?
Oh, 32 copas. Sorry, forgot to say cups.
32 vasos de agua? You drink 32 cups of water?
Oh, no, that's not right. Like, hold on. What's the word I was like? Yeah, that's a lot of water. No, how do I say ounces?
Ounces.
Okay, yeah. I forgot to write that down, and so that's all. I was like, wait a minute, I'm not saying that right. So, okay, what is it?
Onces? Onces, yeah.
And is it spelled the same, or?
No, O-N-Z-A, I think, onces.
Z-A, okay. I was like, wait a minute, I missed something. When I wrote it down this weekend, I wasn't, in my head I was thinking it, but I didn't write it down. Okay, so,
okay.
Si bebo 32 onzas agua cada día.
¿Barres todos los días?
No paro todos los días.
¿Corres, lees el periódico de ayer?
No, leo el periódico de ayer.
¿Aprendes a tocar la guitarra?
No aprendo a tocar la guitarra.
¿Corres por la mañana?
No corro.
¿Vendes algo?
No vendo nada.
Muy bien. I like how you put the double in there. Very good.
Yeah.
¿Qué me prometes hacer después de la clase?
So, try to read my handwriting. Haré, I think is what I put down. Haré mi tarea y estudiar vocabulario español.
Yeah. So the way you could say that here, so you put that into the future, haré, and that's fine. Haré la tarea, that's fine. Then you would need to put estudiar into the future too.
Estudiar.
But to keep with the sentence here, te prometo hacer la tarea y estudiar.
Okay.
Te prometo estudiar, te prometo hacer la tarea.
Okay. Let me write that down. So, say it again.
Te prometo hacer la tarea español.
Okay, te prometo hacer. Okay, te prometo hacer mi tarea. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
And then, so I'll scratch that out. And then, what was the rest? Sorry.
Te prometo hacer la tarea y estudiar.
Y estudiar. Okay. So I'll scratch that out. So, te prometo hacer tarea. Okay. I think I got that right. Okay.
Good. Okay. Aprendes a... Nueve. ¿Siempre prendes una luz en tu casa si es de noche?
Sí. Enciendo las luces.
Use the same verb. Sí. Siempre prendo una luz.
Sí.
Because encender means to light a fire, literally.
Oh. Yes. Okay. So I would say sí, and then prendo.
Sí, siempre prendo una luz.
Okay, sí, siempre. Okay, sí, siempre prendo. And then what'd you say?
So the rest of it's just like it is in the question.
Okay. So, si siempre prendo una luz en mi casa.
Si es de noche.
Si es de noche.
Yeah.
Okay.
So essentially, you're saying I always turn a light on at night.
Okay.
Yeah. ¿Rompes platos de vez en cuando?
So I put no. Soy ciudadoso con mis platos de cristal. I'm trying to say, like, no, I'm always careful with my...
Yo soy cuidadosa.
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 Okay. I wrote it down, but they don't ever, like, whenever it comes out, it doesn't actually say it out loud. So I didn't know what the... Well,
there's two different words. One is cuidado, and the mm-hmm. other is ciudad. There is a ciudad. Ciudad means...
Well, that's city, right?
And then cuida, so it's just the mm-hmm. position of the U and the I. So careful would be C-U-I. Ciudad is C-I-U.
So that's together. What I was getting confused. Okay, I thought it was pronounced the same way because, okay. Okay, so no soy cuidadoso.
Cuidadosa. Yo soy
cuidadosa.
Sí. No rompo platos. No rompo platos porque soy cuidadosa.
Okay, so no rompo platos. Okay. No rompo. Okay. Gotcha. Okay.
Yo rompo platos mucho.
What? Hold on. I'm confused.
I break plates a lot.
No.
Yo no soy...
I drop things a lot, but I don't break plates.
I am clumsy. I break things all the time.
It's yeah.
Absolutely terrible. Okay. ¿De quién te escondes?
Nadie. Would that be right?
Yeah. No me escondo de nadie.
Okay. No me escondo.
De nadie.
No me escondo nadie.
De nadie.
De nadie. Gracias.
De nada. Ángela, ¿cometes muchos errores en la vida?
Okay, so this is what I wrote out. Lo tengo, pero estoy aprendiendo a no dejar que me definen.
So try to think of a simpler way to answer that, because I'm okay. Not sure exactly what you just said there.
Okay.
So the question is, cometes muchos errores en la vida. Do you make a lot of mistakes in the life? I think what you're trying to say.
What I wrote to try to translate out was, I think I put like, I am, but I'm learning not, or I'm trying to learn from them or something.
You're trying to translate that. So try not to translate when you're doing this. Try to just use the question to answer, because that's your, whatever you tried to write out there did not.
Okay.
I think I kind of understood what you're trying to say, but it's not going to translate there very well. So if the question is, do you make mistakes? You need to answer yes or no. Right.
Okay.
And then
so just a simple
and then use the same verb in there. Okay. Right. So do you make mistakes? Yes, I make mistakes. So with the, with that cometer, right.
Okay. So
cometo. Muchos errores en la vida.
Muchos errores.
Yeah. So like that, like just to think about what you just said, it doesn't even in English, do you make mistakes? Yes, I am. Right? That doesn't
make
sense. So.
Yeah. Well, I think what it was is I was trying to figure out how to say like, I do, but I'm trying to learn from them, I think is what I had.
You know. Sí, cometo. So say that then. Sí, cometo errores.
Okay, cometo errores.
Pero aprendo de los errores.
Okay, so sí, cometo errores, pero. And then what'd you say?
How do you say I learn?
Oh, so what I put just.
Aprendo.
Aprendo.
I learn, aprendo.
Aprendo.
Aprendo de ellos.
De ellos.
Little different than what you had written there, right?
Yeah. Less complicated.
All right. Last round of these are IR verbs, okay?
Okay.
So, when you come to an IR verb, you drop the IR and then you add back the N. Okay, repeat after me. Yo o.
Yo o.
Tú es.
Tú es.
Él es.
Él es.
Ella es.
Ella es.
Usted es.
Usted es.
Nosotros imos.
Nosotros imos.
Ellos en.
Ellos en.
Ellas en.
Ellas en.
Ustedes en.
Ustedes en.
So we'll put it together with a verb like vivir. Yo vivo.
Yo vivo.
Tú vives.
Tú vives.
Él vive.
Él vive.
Ella vive.
Ella vive.
Usted vive.
Usted vive.
Nosotros vivimos.
Nosotros vivimos.
Ellos viven.
Ellos viven.
Ellas viven.
Ellas viven.
Ustedes viven.
Ustedes viven.
Muy bien, Angela. All right. Let's see. Let's make sure you know all these verbs. Vivir.
To live.
Escribir.
To write.
Asistir.
I don't know if I actually know the translation for that.
Asistir means to attend or to go to.
Okay.
Tú asistes a las clases de español. You go to Spanish classes.
Asistir. So to attend, you said? Nah. Sorry. Okay.
Recibir.
To receive.
Decidir.
To decide.
Interrumpir.
Now, would that be like to interrupt?
Yes.
Okay. Cool.
Discutir.
To discuss or to argue.
Abrir.
I don't know if I know that word.
Abrir is to open.
Abrir, to open. Okay.
Definir.
Would that be to define?
Very good. Cubrir.
I have no idea what that one is.
To cover.
Huh. Okay. Cubrir. To cover. Okay.
Yeah, so to bring it into modern day life, there's something called a cubre boca.
What is that?
A mouth covering.
Ah.
Or in other words, a mask.
Huh.
Like in the little tiendas around here, like the carnicerias and stuff, they have the sign that says, usa cubrebocas.
Ah, interesting.
Cubrir, to cover. Subir.
Oh, okay, so I've seen that one, but I don't remember what it actually means.
Subir means to go up.
To go up. Like?
Like to go up. To go up.
Oh, okay.
Okay. It can also mean to get into a car or to get on a bus or on an airplane.
Okay.
Last one. Imprimir.
I have no idea.
Imprimir means to print.
Oh. Oh, well, duh, because I did my, like, printer, so that kind of makes sense. To print. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
All right.
So,
do conjugate three of these verbs. Do you already have them?
Yep.
All right, let's hear them.
So I did abrir. Yo abro.
Uh-huh.
Tu abres. Excuse me. Él abre. Ella abre. Usted abre. Nosotros abrimos. Ellos abren. Ellas abren. Ustedes abren.
Muy bien.
Oh, goodness. Then I did imprimir. Yo imprimo. Tú imprimes. Él imprime. Ella imprime. Usted imprime. Nosotros imprimimos.
Muy bien.
Ellos imprimen. Ellas imprimen. Ustedes imprimen.
Okay, bien.
The next one I chose was subir. Yo subo. Tú subes. Él sube, ella sube, usted sube, nosotros subimos, ellos suben, ellas suben, ustedes suben.
Muy bien.
Cool. My throat, just a second. Oh, I hate sinus drainage. Okay. Ella vive lejos de la oficina.
Sí.
Nosotros escribimos cartas a los socios. El, would that be gerente?
Muy bien.
El gerente asiste a las reuniones siempre.
Yeah, so A U E O A, reuniones.
Okay. Okay, I'm on cuatro. Ellos reciben demasiado correo electrónico.
Muy bien.
Los supervisores deciden despedir a un empleado.
Muy bien.
Mi secretaria nunca interrumpe una conversación. Los clientes discuten la conversación.
Muy bien.
El almacén abre a las 9.
Bien.
El abogado define los detalles del contrato. Los trabajadores. I knew I was saying that wrong. Trabajadores suben en el elevador. So this one I was kind of confused on. Mi compañera de trabajo me cubre? Would that be what it is?
Yep.
Okay. El día viernes porque es mi cumpleaños.
Yes.
So
what's your question there?
I was just confused if it was cubre or if it was like cubren. You know, I wasn't sure if it was like a el or if it was they.
Okay. Well, who's the subject?
Compañera?
Yep.
Okay. And that is that like my work friend or my workmate or something?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. I wasn't sure. Yeah. That was confusing on the... Okay. So it's my workmate.
But is it singular or plural?
Oh, that's right. It's singular, so it can't be.
So there you go.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Mis colegas imprimen los informes.
Muy bien.
Yeah, that's it.
You have a question about that one too?
No, I was making sure I finished them all.
Yeah, you got it. Okay, Angela. ¿Escribes poesía?
No escribo poesía.
¿Dónde vives?
Vivo en Belleville, Illinois, en Estados Unidos.
¿Asistes a cada reunión en tu oficina?
No asisto.
¿Recibes noticias buenas todos los días?
No todos los días.
¿Qué imprimes durante tu día de trabajo?
No imprimo.
¿No imprimo nada?
Yeah, that's what I was wanting to say.
Yeah, no imprimo nada.
Okay. Nada. Okay.
¿Siempre aplaudes para los artistas?
Sí. son buenos.
Okay.
Sí, son...
sí.
Hang on. No, that's not what. Okay, hang on. Siempre. ¿Qué significa aplaudos? Aplaudas?
To applaud.
To applaud. Okay.
Wait, your answer was good.
Okay, because I was like, it sounded weird.
If they are good, is what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
The only thing is you didn't answer with the verb. Si aplaudo, si son buenos. Si aplaudo, si son buenos.
Okay.
Yes, so I clap si. If they are good.
Okay, so I would say si aplaudo.
Si son buenos. Mm-hmm. That works.
Aplaudo son buenos. Okay. I circled it because I was like, that it didn't sound right whenever I had just originally had si son buenos. But okay. So si aplaudo.
¿Consumes vino con la cena?
Si a veces. Ugh. Throat.
¿Combates con tu pareja demasiado?
No discutimos. Dimos mucho. Yeah.
¿Abres la puerta para los viejos?
So on that one, I put sí siempre, but should I put sí abro siempre?
So put the siempre up front. Sí, siempre okay. Abro la puerta para okay. Los viejos.
Abro. So, si siempre abro la puerta.
I mean, in a regular conversation, it'd be perfectly acceptable just to say si siempre.
Okay.
I just like the full sentence here because
you're right.
Practicing those verb conjugations and.
Si. Okay.
Bien. ¿Discutes mucho en tu trabajo?
No discuto en mi trabajo.
¿Interrumpes a tu patrón en una reunión?
Okay, so I want to make sure this is the right word because when I looked it up, this is what it said. No, I put no es grosero. So what I'm trying to say is, well, first I got to put the in trumpes or whatever. I got to put that in there. But what I'm trying to say is, like, no, I think it's inappropriate, basically.
Yeah, I would say mal educado.
Okay, so no, and then put mal. What'd you say?
Mal educado.
Okay, E-D-U educado. C-A-D-O?
Yeah, just like educated, educado.
Okay. Educado. Okay. Okay. Got it.
Yeah. I would say that more than grosero in this situation.
Okay. Because I was like, it feels weird putting the, like, I don't know. To me, that sounds like I'm saying, no, that's gross or something, which.
Yeah. Grosero has more of a connotation of.
Disgust.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it does mean rude, but in kind of a different connotation. Mal educado just simply means rude.
Okay.
Like lacking education. I always like the Spanish way of saying rude and polite. So polite is educado.
Okay.
Like someone that is well educated is polite.
Educado.
Uh-huh.
Educado.
And then Somebody that is mal educado, somebody that is poorly educated, is rude.
Okay.
I kind of like that.
Cool. Gracias.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. ¿Qué decides hacer este fin de semana?
So I wrote, voy a limpiar mi coche y leer un libro.
Muy bien.
Okay.
Bien, Angela. Bien. Okay, cool. That is it for today, Angela. So,
Your homework is to do lesson number 5, okay?
Okay.
And you may have already done it.
Yeah.